guys, welcome back to my channel. It's Tussin King and Balu with another banger video. How you guys doing? I'm doing fabulous. I am still here, I'm still alive, and I'm still healthy. I hope all is well with you guys that are watching this. And yeah, so today's video is going to be about how to maintain box braids. I did a recent video like 2 weeks ago on how to style box braids, and now it's time for me to wash my hair. And some people really don't do this stuff when they have box braids. I remember a long time ago when I used to get box braids, I never used to do this stuff. But you guys have to wash your hair, especially when you have box braids, and because it's an essential. Just because you have box braids doesn't mean you still can't wash your hair. And that's the mindset I was thinking in back then, like, how can I wash my hair with these box braids in? But don't worry, like, worry less. I'm here to show you guys how to clean and moisturize your box braids after you're done. So yeah, let's get right into this video. If you guys want to see how I did this, let's just keep
on. So let's see what we're working with.
I'm gonna come up close for you guys to see my hair. Hope you guys can see it. Yeah, I think you guys can see it. This is what I'm working with. You guys can see my front of my hair, the side of my hair. You guys can see all the back of my hair. You can see this one's literally almost coming out. But you guys can see all that good stuff and what I'm working with. And yeah, you guys, another look at the front. I don't know if you can see all those crumbs, all these itchy crumbs. Yeah, it's interesting. Very, very interesting. Let's start with the tips first before we get into the washing. So I know that from when I had box braids, when you first get them, obviously they're gonna be tight. Unless like you specifically request them not to be tight, then they're gonna be a little tight. Like, they're not gonna be extremely loose, obviously. They're gonna be a little bit tight. And you wanna make sure that when you first get them done, you wanna wrap it at night. You don't wanna wrap it too tight, number one, because that's not gonna be good for you. You're gonna have bumps, it's gonna cause irritation, it's not gonna be good. So when you first get your hair done, make sure that your hair lady puts oil in your roots so it can massage it out, so it can decrease the tension that's in your scalp. And then the first night that you know sleep on your head, make sure you sleep on your side. Don't sleep on like your belly. You can sleep on your belly, you can sleep on your belly or your side, but don't sleep on your back, because that's just going to cause irritation, unless you know your pain tolerance is not that high. But that's what I recommend. I also recommend to do is when it starts getting itchy, make sure you pat it. I feel like everyone knows this, but just make sure you pat it. Don't like itch it, because that's gonna just A, cause irritation, B, the roots are gonna start coming up. And the next tip I have is for when it also starts to itch, make sure, or when it starts itching continuously, like it won't stop itching, make sure you get like some type of oil, like tea tree oil, vitamin E oil, hair oil, and put it in your scalp and rub it in. And I promise you, the next day you're not gonna have any itching until like 3 days after. But for now, that's gonna be good. And then when you start realizing that crumbs or like little flakes are popping up in your scalp, that's time. That's a sign that it's almost wash day. And it depends. Like, it could be a week, and you can start. Like, it could be a week after you got your hair done, you can start doing that. It just A, depends on how good your hair lady is. B, how like the maintenance of like how you maintain your hair and the braids in your head. And C is if you wrap your hair at night. Like, you should wrap your hair every night. That's like 100% fact. Like, if you don't wrap your hair at night, then your braids are gonna be looking kind of, you know, worn out in like a week or two. That's just 100% facts. And another thing I want to say is that some people have mixed opinions about this, on how long to keep your box braids in. Honestly, I think a month is perfectly fine. I think anything over a month, it depends. Like, if your hair is hanging out, like I told you guys, like, I don't know if you guys can see this, but like right here, my hair is literally hanging out by the depth of it, basically. So if that's what's happening to your hair, you need to probably start taking out your hair. If it's only like one or two strands, it's okay. Just make sure you keep an eye on it. But if it's majority of your braids doing that, then it's time for it to kick it out. And that could be the cause of, because you haven't been wrapping your hair now, you've just been sleeping with your hair like this. And you know that's not really good. So especially, like, it's just not good for the maintenance of your hair. You need to make sure you maintain your hair. And I mean, like you're saying, hair, your box braids. You need to make sure you maintain your box braids at all costs, because, you know, you paid a good amount of money for it. You probably didn't, but at the end of the day, you still want to wake up with your box braids looking fresh and you, like, you just got them like done 2 days ago type thing. So those are all my tips. And if you keep them in for longer, that's okay, but like if they're like hanging out like this one, then it's time for it to come out. But that's only if like a couple of them are hanging out. But if most of your braids are hanging out, then it's time for to definitely take them out. And another thing, I really apologize for looking like this. Like, I'm about to hop in the shower. I'm about to show you guys how to wash your box braids and all that good stuff. And speaking of which, I'm gonna show you guys the products that I will be using to wash my box braids. It's nothing special, really simple. And just a disclaimer, this is not sponsored. Speaking of not sponsored, let me talk to you guys real quick. So I was on YouTube 2 minutes ago type thing, and I realized that almost all my videos are copyrighted. Like, it's not good. So yeah, I have to like change. I think I have to actually delete all those videos and re-upload them, which sucks because some of them are in the hundreds, and it's just like, Jesus. Yeah, it's gonna be a long road. So just a tip out there, if you're an up-and-coming YouTuber like me, make sure you don't get copyrighted. Make sure that your song is, you know, a song without the words or something like that. But yeah, that's just a disclaimer, guys. But yeah, let's get back into the how-to video. So the two thingies that I'm gonna be using shampoo and conditioner. This is by Alberto VO5. This is, I'm pretty sure you guys have seen this. This is the real ghetto, not real ghetto, but this is the cheap stuff. Yeah, I guess you can say it's the cheap stuff. It looks like this. Let's bring down the brightness of this. Can you guys see it better? Yeah, this is how it looks. VO5, this is the shampoo version, if you guys can't see. And then the next one is conditioner. Let me do it in this way because it's going up and down. Yeah, there you go. It's conditioner, VO5, and I'm using the strawberry kind as usual. I'm gonna bring this brightness up. But yeah, those are the two things I'm gonna be using. It doesn't matter which goes first. Obviously, I'm gonna use shampoo first. And yeah, and then I'm going to show you guys, after I'm done, I'm going to show you guys the hair products that I use to moisturize my scalp as well. So, if you want to see me, wash my hair, keep on.
Yeah. Just through everything around me. Freeze. Get the money, dollar bill, y'all.
We'll be right back. So now that I'm rinsing everything out, I believe that I'm rinsing out my conditioner, making sure that everything is out. This is the last step, at least for me, when I wash my braids. I want to make sure I scratch everything out. Baywatch up in here. But yeah, I just want to make sure everything is out. There's no excess soap, excess shampoo or any conditioner left in my hair. I want to make sure everything is out.
Approximately 10 hours later,
I finished my hair and I finished taking a shower, and now I'm gonna show you guys what I used to moisturize my hair. I have this towel on because my hair is obviously still wet. So let me just show you guys what I moisturize with first. So I moisturize with this Lester's Pink Oil Moisturizer Hair Lotion Original Revives and Protects Vitamin E and Pro Vitamin B5. This is how it looks. You guys can see. It's very nice. I love it. Really good. And then I'm going to use an oil. I'm going to be using my Vitamin E oil that I showed you guys in my nighttime slash skincare routine. This is what I also use on my face too. So yeah, I'm going to be using that. And now we're going to be taking the monster down. Jeez. So now you can guys take another look how fresh and revived it looks. It looks really good. Obviously it's gonna be frizzy, but other than that, thing looks so nice.
Everything looks very nice.
And yeah, we're just gonna be taking everything one by one. So let me go ahead and move that there. Move you here. You guys can see. And we're just gonna be taking a couple, just one pump for now for the pink. And we're gonna be moisturizing it through scalp. Ooh, you guys don't understand how good this feels for my hair to feel nice. And we're gonna take another pump for my hair to feel nice and moisturized again. You gotta be careful with this loose braid down here. I'm gonna just go through the middle, down the middle. See that? And down the middle. All that good stuff. I'm gonna go onto this other side. Do the same exact thing. So I'll be back when I do both sides. I'm done with moisturizing both sides. I'm just squeezing my ends. Jeez, okay. Y'all see my ends? Yeah, they're kinda wet, so I'm squeezing them. This side too. And yeah, I think we're all ready to start with the oil. So I'm not gonna use a lot of oil. All I'm gonna do is go down the middle. Jeez, I see all that. I'm gonna do the same for the back. Basically it. I don't really go in with like a super, I don't go in with a lot of oil basically. And yeah, now I'm just patting everything. And thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a big thumbs up. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. We're on the road to 200, guys. I have like 190 subscribers. And Just a disclaimer, guys, I think I'm going to be taking down a couple, most of my videos, and then re-uploading them just because of the copyright. So that is a disclaimer. If you guys want to check out any of my videos, I'll link them down in the description box below. Like my 14 hairstyles, if you guys want to check that one out, I'm going to link that down. And my nighttime routine, I'm going to link that down also. Like I said, like, comment, subscribe, and stay tuned for the next video. Love you guys.